What's up? Huh? What's up, buddy? Huh? What's going on? Yeah? What's up, Buster?
Hi, Buster. Hi, Buster. What's up, buddy? What? Buster? What? What's up, buddy? What? Buster. Buster. Hey. Where you going? Where you going? Where you going, buddy? What's up, Buster? You back on the drugs? Hey. What's up? Huh? Buster? Buster? Hey. What's up, pal? What's up, pal? Huh? What's up, buddy? How you feeling? You weird? Or am I weird? Who's weird here? Who's weird, Buster? Yeah, look at that. Look at that mug. What's up? What's up? Huh? Come on. What? 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 Huh? What's up, Pally? You did good at the vet. Yeah. So, I did. It's a later today. It's later. Where you going, man? Where you going? I'll get him another cat eventually. But this guy at the vet, like, no problem. No problem with the box. No problem socializing. No freaking out. Wasn't too weird afterwards. This situation is ridiculous. It happened twice. All I'm trying to get is a guitar stand. Use whatever options you have at your disposal to maintain your sanity without hurting yourself or others. All right? Am I too fucking close? Oh, man. Look. I don't know when I'm going to get a new cat. Here's the deal with Buster. I don't know what I told you guys. I wanted to thank some people for some stuff because I opened it here. Tiny Needles, you there? You sent me, what did you send me? A book of poems, I think, and some other stuff, and some nice pencils, I believe. Thank you. Thank you. Poems in this book, In Love with the World by Yanghi Mengor Rinpoche. This is a life changer book, right? Look at the nice painting. Be kind to yourself. I don't want guitar wall hangers. Someone sent me the Daily Stoic, 366 Meditations on Wisdom, Perseverance, and the Art of Living. Okie dokie. But thank you. Thank you for the nice things. I don't always do this because I don't always open them here, but I'm here. So anyways. Oh, man. Fuck it. So Amazon, like, I ordered a guitar stand like the other ones I have. I just want one more. This is the second time they just sent me a large roll of plastic. like a giant roll of this heavy duty clear plastic. I sent it back once, and then I ordered the guitar stand again, second time, plastic. All right, what's going on here? So, whoa, hey, watch it. Whoa, so, take it easy. I've only got some of the lab work. Yeah, just a giant roll of plastic, dude. It was supposed to be a guitar stand twice. And they sent me a label the first time to just drop it off at UPS, but this time I've got a code that I got to bring to UPS to get a label. I mean, what the fuck? So I just got a refund this time, and I ordered a wooden one for 6 guitars, because I guess I'm that guy. Just because, I don't know. I like the guitar. I like the stands I got, the Hercules stands. I like them, but I just can't seem to get one from Amazon. So I've only got some of the lab work back from Buster, but the initial lab work that they could do at the vet was good. It's the one that detects early kidney disease. He doesn't have it. His heart is good. But as expected from the ultrasound, I think I discussed this yesterday, he's probably working primarily with one kidney. And he's chubby, and his teeth are dirty. But I'll get all the other labs. I'll get the blood and pee labs coming. So, but he's still acting weird, and I'm focused on him. I'm obsessed, but I have to understand that maybe I'm causing him to act weird. This always happens with me and cats. I'm stressed, so I dump it on them, and I start hyper-focusing on them, and I'm kind of like, you're acting a little weird. You're a fucking cat. Of course you're acting weird. That's what fucking cats do. Cats are weirdos. Why is he sleeping in that place now? No one knows the answer to these questions. I've had cats for like almost 20 years. Like they go through phases, man. One day they're sleeping on the table. Then for a few months they're sleeping on the chair. And then for a year they're sleeping, you know, on top of the couch. Sometimes they're shitting on the rug for a month or two. What? I don't know. It just seems to be what's happening. Look, now they're destroying that chair. When did that stop? I don't know, but it stopped. It's just the way it is. Yeah, he sleeps with me sometimes. It's like, what, you don't like this thing anymore? When did that happen? This is not your blanket anymore? Now it's my shirt? Okay. How long is that going to go on for? Can I move the shirt? You just don't know. You don't know. I've asked Cat Stevens. Cat Stevens, Buddha, Stevens, what? Can you explain a cat to me? No. Yeah, but I've had drug dreams lately. I had another dream about someone I used to know, someone who used to work for me, kind of. And it was the weirdest dream. And then I reached out to her, and she'd gotten hit by a car. Had a terrible time of it for the last few months. Like, bad. But she was happy to talk to me. It's weird when people show up in your dreams to be like, you know, hey, how's it going? Maybe you ought to check in with me because it's been a rough time. I'm like, all right, well, you could have just texted. You didn't have to go through all the trouble of jumping onto the astral plane to plop into my head in a way that was sort of coded and strange and involved weed and New York and stuff. But either way, if that was easier than texting, given your predicament, to jump on the astral plane and kind of get into my unconscious, I'm all for it. I'm not on the weed, but there was weed in the dream. Yeah, I wanted to buy weed. I was in New York and I needed to buy weed, and I knew this person was a weed dealer, but she's not really a weed dealer. But I couldn't remember her name, but I knew her pretty well. And then I found her, and sure enough, I remembered her name, but she wasn't a weed dealer. But we ended up just going to her apartment and hanging out on the couch and smoking weed. And kind of like, you know, snuggling, kind of. Which was not the thing that was not the relationship. But it was kind of nice to see her, so I reached out, and it turned out she had this horrible accident. Have I seen the doc about Jim Belushi's weed farm? I can't watch that guy do anything. My dad has COVID. He's 78. And he just had blockage cleared from his carotid. He probably got it in the hospital because it's been taking all precautions. Now he's in the ICU on a ventilator. I'm sorry. That's fucking terrible. It's fucking terrible. Yeah, the forecast is not good. Viral clouds are moving over into LA and across the country. I gotta start work. No, she was not in New York. She was never in New York. I'm trying to take care of myself, man. I just worked out. I gotta do a phone call about COVID protocol. I gotta fucking do, I gotta do a fitting. I got tested on Saturday. My dad's birthday was a couple of days ago. 82. I'm not gonna be filming in New York. I'm not going anywhere. The movie shoots like an hour and a half from here. Hour and 15 minutes. I don't know what their plan is for this character. I'm gonna go try the clothes on today. And, see where they're at. I know I picked some glasses. I know they told me to let my face grow out so they had something to work with. I think they're gonna test me every other day. My dad's okay. Sobriety is definitely not boring. Think about what a bore you are when you're not sober. Brr, look at me. I'm so fun. I'm having a lot of fun in my head. Sobriety is fucking on fire. Because then you get to know who you are and what your brain is. Yeah. I've not seen Glenn Wool's new special. I've not heard that name in a while. How's that lunatic doing? Oh, man. Stoner laugh. Oh, dude, we're having such a good time. Oh, man. No way. Oh, bro. Hey, man. Yeah, that's much more exciting. There's nothing more insane than fucking sobriety. Jesus Christ. First 5 years of sobriety. That was like the most fucked up trip I've ever been on in my life. It's crazy. It's fucking nuts. Tomorrow I talk to James Densmore. Is that his name? John Densmore, the drummer for The Doors. Bro, oh man. Dude, oh, come on. I don't make breakfast tacos. Your sister just got 12 years, that's fucking good. 2 days away from a year, do it, man. John Densmore put together a book about his interactions with people, artists. He's okay. He's all right. It's okay. All right. You're trying to get your daughter to stop smoking. That is the dumb one. Man, I could not get off of that shit. I could not get off of that shit. The nicotine, man. Fuck it. I gotta go fucking send this roll of plastic back. It's a fucking roll of plastic. 500 days. Congratulations. All right, man. 500 days. Dude. Oh, yeah. I'm chewing the gum like a madman. Yeah, I was on the lozenges forever. Squirrely. Squirrel. Squirrel guy. Hey, squirrel. It's my friend, the squirrel. That's how I talk to all animals. What's up? Where are we at with this? Crow, what's going on? Squirrely. Hey, Buster. What's up? Doggy. What inspired me to get sober? I was gonna die. And my life was falling apart. What usually inspires someone to get sober? Here's when you need to get sober. It's like, oh fuck, man, I'm fucked up, and everything's fucked up, and I can't stop. Why am I still fucked up? I want to stop, but I can't stop getting fucked up. And then there's some miracle in that moment. You don't want to stop. Is there any way to approach someone abusing alcohol about sobriety? Nope. There is not. All you can do is let them know that help is there when and if they ever choose to do it. Kills a lot of people. It's a bad scene. I just started reading Gabor Mate's book. I don't know why it took so long. I've been sitting on it forever. I mean, in program speak, when you have a problem, it's when, you know, if you make a list of the times that you said you were going to stop and didn't, and why you didn't. Like, this is the time I wanted to stop drinking. I tried to stop drinking. Then this happened, and I didn't stop. If you make a list and you look at that, and you're sort of like, holy fuck, I can't stop on my own. That's clear from this list. Then your life is unmanageable because of using and drinking. It's a pretty easy equation. Yeah, I don't do anything, man. I haven't done anything in whatever it is. How long has it been? 21 years or something? Yeah, there's plenty of people that can drink and do drugs all they want. Yeah, it's all relative to... Yeah, no one can judge anybody else. It really is the individual person saying, like, my life is fucked and I can't stop on my own. That's all there is to it. There's nothing you can do for people who like it and manage it and that's their life. Everyone's got their own choices. Life is short and that's that. You know? Some people, you know, are fine. Doesn't matter. Yeah, family history is important, but still it's like... All that's going to give you is knowledge. It's not going to stop you from getting fucked up. How long are my meditations? I do like 10 minutes. I do 10 minutes. 10 to 12. I mean, he talks. He's like, everybody is heartbroken. We all carry our pain with us. And then it's like 10 minutes. Polly's in here. The wheeze. Hey, buddy. What's up, buddy? Polly Shore. Yeah, everybody's wandering around Instagram. Hey, buddy. Oh, man. No way. You know what my favorite thing to do when I was at the Comedy Store and I went on before Pauly Shore? I just love to do it. And he was a relatively good sport about it. He'll remember if he's still here. Oh, it was I'd go on after him usually. And he was one of the guys at the store that he liked the lights turned down. You know, does he still talk like that? He kind of does, but it's just the way he talks. What Pauly will do is he'll like do his bit about what it was like to be the wheeze. And then by the end of the bit, he's kind of the wheeze again. No, I'm not pulling Pauly into this. But the thing I used to love to do, and it worked every time. Was I'd follow him and I'd get on stage and I'd be like, Pauly Shore, and they'd applause. And then I would go, yep, that's what he looks like now. It works so good every time because people haven't seen him in a while. I remember when Pauly started because I was a doorman then and he didn't really like me particularly, but we have gotten closer. I do that outro with David Spade sometimes too. The people that people haven't seen in a while. It's like foolproof. Sorry, buddy. Hey, buddy. Hey, buddy. Sorry, man. Oh, dude. Go watch his new movie. I think he's got a new movie. Damn, lots of judgmental humans here. Yeah, yeah. Comment boards are the fucking worst. Welcome to reality. No, not the jury duty one. He's in someone where he lives with some people or something, or he rented part of his house. Am I a fan of Stan Hope? You mean Doug Stanhope? Yeah. Yeah. No one does what Doug does, that's for sure. Paulie just had a movie come out. Yeah, House Guest, something like that. Yeah. I went Spicoli for a minute. It's close. There's definitely a crossover between the early Wheeze and Spicoli. I remember Paulie when he was just a kid and he wasn't the Wheeze yet. And he would just show up in this sort of like weird surfery kind of outfit and he just would do that voice. And then it evolved. Hey, buddy. Hey, buddy. Hey, buddy. It evolved into the Wheeze. Why am I not seeing him? Is he not saying anything? Where'd I get this jacket? Good question about Dennis Miller. What about Dennis Miller? Is House Guest on Netflix? I don't know if he's on here. Hey, Paulie, where's that movie? Tell people where the movie is. Paulie's jokes about his stepdad, mom's boyfriends are odd. about all the comics that his mom fucked? Yeah. Yeah, it is funny. It's funny. Yo, there he is. My bros. Dude, where can they watch your movie? Oh, yeah, I put that James Caan. December 18th on Netflix. Really? I know you wanted to come on the podcast again, but that's a lot, right? December 18th on Netflix. We'll get it out there, buddy. We'll get it out there, buddy. Bro, dude, Paulie. Hey, buddy. What are you doing, man? Why are you up? Where are you? Are you in Palm Springs? Are you in Hawaii? What are you doing? This is my show business, Paulie. This is what we're doing now. Buddy. Well, I have Dennis Miller on. He was supposed to come on at some point. And he didn't want to because he was afraid that I would, you know, grill him about politics. I do remember Gigi Allen. He was a shit clown. Gigi Allen was a shit clown, a Lower East Side shit clown that people thought was inspired because he was a shit clown. He likes to play with his own shit on stage. I'll do Stern again, but he just had me on the one time. And that was it. He doesn't give a shit about me. He's doing Belzer. Yeah, Dennis Miller, he was nervous to come on because he didn't want to talk about politics with me. And I don't give a fuck. I was going to talk about comedy. I was never a huge fan. But whatever. You know, he was important. The Weasel on MTV equals the best days of our lives. There you go, Paulie. Gigi Allen, it's weird. I remember, like, I saw just a trailer for that fucking, for that documentary. And I'd forgotten that he had that weird, dumb brother of his. He's not dumb. I don't know these guys. But Gigi Allen's brother used to walk around the Lower East Side with his strange Hitler mustache. And all I ever knew was, like, that's Gigi Allen's brother. You like Dennis's brother? Which one? There's a couple. Jimmy's solid. And the other one... Jimmy's a manager, and then there's, oh, fuck, come on. Rich. Rich and Jimmy Miller. Rich is a booker and promoter, and he's okay. I'm okay with Rich, and Jimmy's a good guy. Jimmy's always been a friend of mine. Yeah, they're all Pittsburgh guys. Todd Phillips directed the Gigi Allen documentary. Yeah. I don't know. Gigi was not my thing. Are you friends with Norm MacDonald? I love Norm. I don't know if we're friends, but, you know, we're not friends. I've talked to him. I like him. He's an odd sort. Cat Stevens. I'm not going to hike. I worked out. Hold on. Look at that asshole. What's up, buddy? What's with the ring? What ring? F20? You're already in? We're already doing it? F20? Hey! What's up? Buster. What are you doing? Come here. Come on. What's up? No second show? No second show? Yeah. Hi, buddy. Yeah. What's up, pal? Yeah? Yeah. What's going on? What? You all right? You're a one kidney guy. Oh. Look at that. That ring is a one-of-a-kind ring that a fan made years ago. I don't even think he was a jeweler. F12. Let's get this shit up and going. I don't want to explain the game to Polly. Look, if we're not careful, Polly will make this all about him. This is my show! This is my show. Hey, buddy. F12, was that it? One, two, three, four, five, six, seven, eight, nine, 10, 11. Whoa. Yeah. Dude, not bad. Here we go. John Fahey. Polly said, his mom says, you're fired. You're fired. You're not funny. No, we're not doing Blind Joe Death. Oh, yeah, it is Blind Joe Death. These are kind of rare records. I don't know if it's going to be, you know, it's not going to be a party. That's not a day starter. It's great. It's a great record. It's a great record. My most metal album? Huh. I'm not a metal guy, but I might have something.
My most metal album. That's a good question. Like, what's traditionally considered metal? I think I had this. What's up, buddy? Yeah? Do I still have that fucking... Oh. I think this might be... This might be my most metal album. Do you know this band? Let's see if I'm... I might be wrong. I might be wrong, but I believe this is probably my most metal album. But I don't know. I can't remember. Let's see. It's so metal that people can't even identify it. Hold on. Maybe I'm wrong. Let's see. Come on, give me a riff. Yeah, that is, that's my most metal album. That's a band called Krellis. I don't know where they're from. But there you go. Krellis. Krellis. All right. Let's do one more record. Then I got a piece. Krellis. Well, you asked, someone asked me, what's my most metal album? That's it, man. Yeah, you asked for it, you got it. Do I like Fiona Apple's new record? Yeah. N12? Okay, that's it. And then we're going to do that, and then I got to go because I got to pee and stuff and shower. And oh, shit, what time is it? I got to get on this call. N12? All right. Do I have harder metal? Maybe. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5. I've been here before. No, I'm not playing this. What is this? Is this negative land? What is this? What do you make of this? Huh? I don't even know what this is. Do you? I feel like it's a... What the fuck, man? I don't know what this is. But it was with the Negative Land stuff. I'll have to ask Peter. Let's see.
2, 1, 2, 3, 4. Fred, thanks for holding.
Oh, my pleasure. I was listening to the evening's conversations, and I was trying to pray with you as you were praying earlier, and I noticed I haven't been able to do it very well lately. I've been getting nervous, not being able to concentrate very well. I wonder if you could help me with that.
On how to pray?
Yeah.
I would just keep practicing, and when your mind wanders, bring it back, focus it in on what you're praying about, and continue to pray.
Well, yeah, I have limited success some of the time.
Mm-hmm.
For example, I find that I can master.
He does have it.
All right, so this is sort of bordering on a comedy record. How do you spell Krellis? You spell Krellis K-R-A-L-L-I-C-E. K-R-A-L-L-I-C-E. All right, so that's what that is. It's a weird phoner show. I'm gonna look where this came from. All right, one more. Come on, let's get some music going. Let's go. New York band? Which one? M8. Okay. We'll try it. Buster. M8. Fine. And then that's it. I got 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8. Oh, yeah, okay. Fuck yeah. Oh, fuck yes. Yes, you guys. Thank you. Thank you. Oh, yeah. Oh, yeah, man. Magnolia Electric Company. Jason Molina. This is the best. Fuck yes. This song kills me. Oh, yes. Yes. Fucking Jason. Oh. Let's go. Major label. Man, this song fucking makes me cry all the fucking time. Oh, God. I think this is not going to get flagged. It's on like Northern. What is his label? I can't even remember. Wow. It's under Songs Ohio. See, was it secretly Canadian? I didn't realize that, man. I didn't realize Albini mixed that thing. God damn, I love that record. Okay, so Buster. Buster. Hey. Hey, buddy. It's a great record, yeah. Hey. Yeah? Okay. Well, we're all gonna go. Secret Canadian, I think. All right, you guys. Take it easy. Have a good day. I'm gonna pee. I have to pee. And I've been holding it for you. I've been holding it to entertain. And I don't even have to. Use whatever options you have at your disposal to maintain your sanity without hurting yourself or others. Buddha face. See you later, Cat Stevens. Too close, you fucks.